Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom Vlog. And this is going to be my last episode I record today because I got to go to work in about an hour. It's the day after Free Comic Book Day. So if you haven't checked out my Free Comic Day videos, definitely go check those out and watch our previous episode where we talked about Spider-Man 3 The Black, which was like a one-shot comic that came out with the DVD and Blu-ray, I think, of Spider-Man 3. Maybe just the DVD, I can't remember. But it came out with that and I found it on eBay, picked it up because you guys recommended it to me. So thank you so much for doing that. I had a lot of fun reading that and sharing my thoughts with it in the previous episode. But in this one, we're going to go back to our Venom Versus, and we're going to do a really interesting one because I don't know how many of you have read this book, but I remember picking up the first issue way back when and never ever actually finding the second issue and then forgetting all about it. So recently, I just ordered the second issue on eBay, and now we can officially talk about it because I read them both last night, which is Backlash versus Spider-Man. And this was a comic crossover from Image Comics that came out in the 90s, and it's during the Clone Saga. So Spider-Man is actually Ben Reilly in this storyline. And you have Backlash here, and I'm blanking on the girl's name. We're gonna probably see it here when I flip through the artwork. You know, she's this, the three of them kind of teaming up against a villain named Pike and Venom. Yes, and if those of you out there who are following the new Donnie Kate stuff, where Venom, or Carnage at least, is going around tracking down everyone who's ever had a piece of the symbiote to, like, you know, rebuild the Grendel costume, then he better make a trip over to the Image universe and find Pike, because Pike does bond with the Venom symbiote very briefly in this issue. So it's kind of fun. This book, I gotta say, the writer, it's written by Ruffner and Booth. Brett Booth, who's actually the artist of the book and co-creator of Backlash. Backlash was co-created by him and Jim Lee in the early 90s from Image Comics. And so this is a Jim Lee creation. And it would have been cool, like, I love Brett Booth's artwork, but it would have been cool to see, like, you know, Jim Lee be a part of this in some way. I'm sure he was, like, on a behind the scenes level. But it would have been cool to get, like, a pinup in here of Venom by Jim Lee or something like that. That would have been really awesome. I know a lot of people, when the Image Marvel stuff was crossing over, they wanted Spawn to cross over and maybe do a Spawn Venom. But for whatever reason, they never did do that, which I thought was kind of a missed opportunity in my mind. But this book still, it's kind of fun. I mean, these characters, these Image characters, they all kind of felt like they were cut from the same cloth, like Wildcats kind of thing. But I thought they were interesting. The way they tell the story is pretty interesting because you have Spider-Man, who is Ben Reilly, who is still coming to terms with that. And so you have this kind of reluctant, you know, not so confident Spider-Man, which kind of works in the storyline. And then you have these characters, Backlash, and this girl who is part of a science experiment where a scientist named Bonham, I think his name was, he created a symbiote very much like the Venom one, but his version of symbiote, which is black and oozy, is actually for vampires to protect them during the daytime. So basically they have vampire friends that, you know, in the Image universe that are like good guys. And they're like, hey, we want to protect them when they have to go into battle against other forces. Obviously they have a big weakness. There's like, you know, 10 or 12 hours of the day that they can't actually go out in and fight. And people need to be protected at all times. So I created the symbiote to basically protect them. It'll go over their skin. It'll protect them from sun rays. And I thought that was kind of a neat thing, like a way to introduce this. And then Venom reads this woman as an actual symbiote. He thinks, you know, and the symbiote thinks that it's from Clintar because of the texture and the abilities of it and everything. And it's not till they get close to her that they realize that she's not really a true symbiote and she's not a spawn of Carnage, because that's who Venom is labeling her as. He's like, oh, you're a spawn of Carnage, so I'm going to destroy you the way I destroy Carnage. You know, I try to destroy Carnage and every other symbiote and all the other, like, Life Foundation symbiotes. So Venom's kind of on that kick, and he's after her for that reason. And he was hired by this guy Pike, who, you know, was supposed to go get her himself, and he is like, you know what, I did some research on her, and I did some research on this world, this Marvel world, I guess, and I learned about this Venom guy, so I'm gonna have Venom go after her and kind of feed him lies and make him think that she's, you know, Spawn of Carnage or some kind of evil symbiote, and I'm gonna use him to do all the dirty work in case other heroes get involved, and then I'll sneak in and take her and, you know, and get my bounty or whatever it is that he got, you know, hired to do. And so at first you get a little bit of Venom fighting Pike. But then that's when Pike is like, no, let's like, you know, let's team up. I'm hiring you for a reason. I need you to help me with something. There's a loose symbiote, you know, there's a symbiote on the loose, and I need your help with it. So Venom is ready to kick the crap out of Pike, and Pike's like, you know, kind of talks him down. So that's kind of where the book starts. And then from there, you have Venom kidnap the girl, and, you know, and reveal her symbiote side. And then you have Ben Reilly actually here in a Fantastic Four shirt, which I thought was pretty fun that they did that. And he's, you know, thinking about his life as Scarlet Spider, becoming Spider-Man, what that's meant to him, what's going on. And then he sees this tussle going on, just kind of coincidentally sees this fight going on, and jumps in. You know, as Spider-Man, he's like, all right, I got to get involved. And I see Venom, and I can't not fight Venom. I'm the one who took him down as Scarlet Spider. I was the first time that a Spider character, like, physically beat, you know, Venom with his fists, like, to knock out, you know? And so Ben is like, I got to do this. I got to jump in and help out. So, of course, his instinct is to help her. And then Venom's like, don't you understand, Spider-Man? She's another symbiote. And he's like, another symbiote? And he's like, yeah, but she seems innocent. Like, and she really does. I know she looks dark and twisted and everything, but her mannerisms, the way she's acting, her eyes are really kind of big and sympathetic looking. And Eddie's like, you know, not having it. He's like, no, you know, I need her. She could be the key to something, or she could be another symbiote that I have to destroy. And this guy Pike or whatever, and then Pike shows up and gets involved. And then there's like, you know, kind of a three-way battle there with them. And then the woman's trying to get away, but then, you know, they are unable to get her because when Spider-Man turns back around, Venom has taken the lady away and Pike has gone with him. What? Because like Spider-Man does like one of those where he turns this way, Venom's gone with the girl, and then he turns back and Pike is gone. And it's like, okay. And then that's when Backlash shows up, and then him and Spider-Man have to team up in issue 2 to go hunt them down. So this is a 2-issue story. I'm pretty sure because it's a crossover with Image and Marvel, it has not been reprinted anywhere. So I think if you want to read this, you're going to have to go pick up these books either on eBay or milehighcomics.com or at like a back issue bin at a comic store somewhere. I'm sure you'll find them for really cheap. They were $2.50 when they came out, but actually I was able to buy this on eBay for like $2. And then this one I've had for quite a while now. So yeah, I'm excited. So this, you know, this second part here is really neat because it really ramps it up. And you have Venom here talking to the girl. He's realizing that maybe she is an innocent, that her symbiote isn't exactly what it seems to be. And then he, you know, that's when Venom starts questioning Pike, and he's like, not, you know, feeling what, you know, Pike is now saying. And he's like, Pike is like a very smooth talker, and he's talked Venom with his silver tongue into doing things. And Venom's kind of like, I don't like being a patsy. And he's like, so I'm going to try to figure out what this guy's really up to. And meanwhile, you have Spider-Man and Bonham and these like different, or Branham, that's his name, the scientist that created it. They're talking about the symbiote and what it is. And that's when, you know, Ben here gives the lowdown. He's like, hey, well, there's this guy that I knew that fought in these wars on another planet with the other heroes. He, you know, I guess he was Spider-Man at the time, and he got this costume and brought it to Earth. And that's all I know about it. And they're like, well, that's different from our suit. The suit we created was meant to help vampires and things like that. And you know, and he's like, vampires? Because I'm sure on some level, Peter's like, or Ben is thinking of like maybe Michael Morbius, like, oh, maybe we can help Michael Morbius with this. Or maybe Peter would have thought that, but Ben is more like, oh, vampires, what are you talking about, vampires? And he's like, yeah, there's vampires, and some of them are good, and we wanted to make the suit to help them out from sun rays. And so that's when you get that explanation for what the suit does. So once they kind of compare notes and everything, they're like, all right, well, maybe we can track Venom, because we have a sample of a symbiote, we'll put it in this device, and maybe you guys can track him and bring it back to its original source. So Spider-Man's like, I'm down for that. And Backlash like, cool, me too, let's do it. So they go out and try to find Venom. Of course, the tracker works, brings them right to Pike, brings them right to the girl, brings them right to Venom, and they get into a big battle, which is, you know, the battle and the art is really good. And at the end here, when basically Pike's plan is revealed, because this guy who's like his kind of his eyes on the street, like Pike has like a guy who just kind of like a goon on the, you know, on the streets and everything, he came up and he's like, hey, I took a couple cars, I ditched the cops, and I found my way here. And he's telling this plan, and Pike's like, wait, stop it, why are you revealing, what's going on, why are you revealing the plan? And Venom's like, yep, that's what I thought, you are a liar. So I'm like, oh, that's great, like, you know, Eddie kind of trying to use his brain, you know, here, and not just being like a total goon himself, is figuring out things on Pike and luring people that knew Pike like to their location. But then of course that also brings Spider-Man and Backlash too, because Venom being there, you know, they were able to track him through that the technology that Backlash has, because he's like part alien and stuff, and so he has this alien technology that he used to put the symbiote in, and they brought it, you know, tracked him right back to Venom here. So Backlash and Venom get into a fight. where Spider-Man knocks Pike out pretty quickly, which I thought was fun. I was like, they did it for a nice comedic moment where he webs up and then he punches him on the top of the head and knocks him out. But, you know, Venom and Backlash, they actually go at it for a full page. And Backlash holds his own pretty well, but he's ultimately thinking he's going to lose this fight until he grabs a symbiote and he says, you know what, you're missing a piece of your symbiote. Here, go get it. And when he throws it, unfortunately, Pike grabs it and Pike bonds with that. And it makes like a Pike Venom creature, which, you know, it looks neat, actually. I like the energy glowing out of him. So, of course, the symbiote, like it did with Spider-Man, it just kind of copies and mimics his powers and kind of enhances them in some ways. His strength, you know, his mind, everything like that, his webbing even. But in this one with Pike, he's got an energy-based power, almost like Gambit, where he can like charge things up or has like a glowing rod that he can fight with. And so now this his version of Venom has that power. So I thought that was kind of neat that they did that and they, you know, made like a new character out of him. So then the rest of the book is actually a big battle with Venom. The girl whose name is Amanda, I can't remember her superhero name, but her name is Amanda. I just read it on one of the pages. And sorry, I was blanking on that for a minute there. So you have Amanda, you have Venom, you have Spider-Man, you have Backlash, and they're all fighting this Pike symbiote now. And that's pretty much what the whole book is. And you even have Venom trying to rebond with the suit. He jumps on the back of Pike. You can see how big he is compared to Venom. And he's saying, like, remember me, remember us. Like, you know, come back to us, come back to us. And Pike has such a control over the symbiote, it's not leaving him. So they're fighting and everything. And that's when Spider-Man realizes, he goes, you know what? We're in a church. And they're like, Amanda's like, so what? Like, you want to go ask God for help? And he's like, no. He's like, well, yeah, no. Like, follow me. Let's lead Venom and Pike upstairs. So they lead them upstairs, and Venom is kind of wise to their idea, and he goes, oh, I understand what's going on, which I thought this was great. This was a great moment from the writers and the storytellers to tie this back into the first appearance and battle of Spider-Man and Venom. I thought it was really cool, because what they do is they lead Pike up to the roof, and that's when you know, Backlash gets a hold of Pike, and Spider-Man rings the bell and separates Pike from the symbiote, which I was like, oh, that's so great. Like, that's a great way to tie it back in to the original battle of Spider-Man versus Venom. And then also Pike not knowing that that could be a weakness, because he's trying so hard to shut the mind of the symbiote out of his mind. You know, he's trying to keep it out of him to fully bond with it so he can be in control of it. So it's great. So the answer was right there in his head the whole time. And, you know, but because the symbiote wants to get away probably and go back to Eddie, it decides, you know what, I'm not going to tell him. This will hurt, but we'll, you know, we'll be able to rebond with Eddie. So, yeah, the church bells goes off. Spider-Man defeats Pike, and the symbiote separates away and goes back to Venom. And Venom, once again, is whole again. And so maybe that's why they won't do it in the Donny Cates crossover, because maybe Venom actually pulled out every single bit of the little bit of symbiote that was in there, because that's what it kind of looks like he does a little bit. But at the same time, it's like, I don't know, that'd be cool to see Backlash, or them mention, like, oh yeah, the Carnage goes like, oh, I had to go fight this Backlash guy and I got his symbiote back or whatever. That would be kind of neat to mention, but I guess that means he would have to kill Backlash, and I don't know if Image wants to get rid of that character or not. But if they do that, bring Brett Booth back to draw the issue, because since it's his creation, it would be cool to see him do it. So, you know, at the end, that's pretty much the story. At the end, you know, Amanda is being held hostage by Pike, and he has like a detonator, and he's like, I'm going to, you know, detonate this. And Venom goes, he's bluffing, and just like shoots a webbing that knocks Pike off the side of the church. But then he grabs Amanda, and that's when Backlash comes in and Spider-Man, and they save Amanda. But then Pike falls, you know, basically what they think to his death. But before he fell, he threw the bomb into the church, into the clock tower. And so all the heroes, after they save Amanda, have to jump out. And as the clock tower blows up. So I was like, all right, that's cool. Like a little bit of action right there at the end. But then they talk about how they swept the ocean and the nearby water. Because of course it was like a church near a cliff all of a sudden. So when they find that, you know, they couldn't find Pike's body, it's like, all right, well, Pike's probably still out there. But, you know, and Venom's still out there somewhere, now reunited with all of his symbiote. And then you have Spider-Man, who's, you know, still out there as well. And Backlash and his team are kind of coming in to clean up the scene at the end of the book, because he's part of like a government kind of group as well, like a kind of a think tanky government type thing. So anyway, I thought the book was fun. Like, rereading these was a lot of fun. I thought this would make a great and interesting episode, because it's not it's a versus, but it's not a versus with a Marvel character outside of Spider-Man. So you have like Amanda and you have Pike and you have Backlash, and these are all like new threats and new things to Eddie Brock and to us and to me, you know, on the channel. Because I was like, you know what, I remember buying this and having it because I wanted part of my Venom collection, but I think I maybe only read this once, and I never, and I was like, and after I saw To Be Continued, I was like, maybe one day I'll find the other book. And then just randomly last week I was on eBay and I was like, you know what, let's see, like, if I can find the second part of this. So when I did, I was like, great. I ordered it, got in like 2 or 3 days, and I'm like, perfect. Now I can, you know, do a whole episode based on these. So thank you to the person who sold this to me on eBay, and thank you, all of you guys, for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Have you read these books? If you have, let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you haven't, you know, let me know what you think. If you have any questions about anything, something I didn't clarify, something I messed up, or you think I got wrong, let me know down below, and we'll continue our conversation down there. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, we have more Venom versus coming up. I'm actually going to do a fun Venom versus Peter Parker episode, and it's going to be a story from a book called Spider-Man Family, and it was like a one-shot annual thing with a bunch of little short stories in it, but I figured that would be a cool, it was actually a neat story, and I think both Spider-Man fans and Venom fans will be really happy with it. So if you haven't read that, I'd recommend looking it up. It's really good, and we're going to talk about that in an upcoming episode, and then we're also going to travel to the future and talk about Venom 2099, where he bonded with someone else and fought a different Spider-Man of the future. So we'll get into that episode very, very soon as well. And then hopefully we'll get some more movie news coming up. We'll get some other stuff. I'll try to switch it up, talk about, you know, non-comic things as well. You know, I'll try to do the best balancing act I can on the show. As always, I'll do my best for you guys. But if you have any recommendations, anything you'd like me, you know, to talk about, any verses that you want to see in the comics that were there, let me know what they are in the comments below, and I'll let you know whether I have them planned already or if we can squeeze them into our schedule. So thank you as always. I really do appreciate it. Like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you all in the future. Peace.